Thank you very much for watching all these episodes on QML, and you might be eager, I hope at least, to learn more and possibly even learn more from me. And for that, I have a good news for you. I have been recording more than 50 episodes now in a series called Qt Widgets and More. And you're like, hey, wait, Jesper, Qt Widgets, come on, I'm in QML. Well, and more, the and more part has lots of material that's interesting for you as a QML developer, assuming at least that you heard what I said in the very first episode in this series, namely business logic go where? In C++. So you likely have lots of C++ code by now, and that C++ code, there's lots of material for you in Qt Widgets and More. Let me just look at my list here, just to give you a few examples for that. So there is 2 episodes on speeding up compilation of that C++ code using pre-compiled headers, using clang instead of GCC, using Ninja instead of Meg, and so on. Very, very good episode for you to read or to watch if you have just the tiniest bit of C++ code. There are an episode of how to use clang-format, very useful tool actually for C++ site. There are a number of Git tips, and I'll show you my Git hooks, which helped me with my C++ code, but that could equally well work with QML code. There are lots and lots of episodes on model view, which is one of those things that I myself do a lot. The view part, of course, is QListView. That's a widget class. But the model part, if you are using QML, could be a list view or the tree view from Qt Quick Controls. And in both situations, you need a model from C++. Very good material for you there. So we've created a playlist that is linked below here on these topics from Qt Widgets and More, that is in the part and more, that would make sense for you as a QML developer. And we'll continue to update that playlist as more and more episodes come in. So hopefully I'll see you there. And until then, have a great time.